Thank you for joining Pioneer. My name is Aaron Pence. I'm from the Norman Central Library. I appreciate you spending a few minutes with me today. I want a lot of stars in our sky. A lot. So let's make them. The first thing is to draw a star sprite. That's pretty easy because stars at this distance look like dots. Point at the Choose a Sprite button and click Paint. Click on the Circle tool. Change the fill color to a bright yellow, almost white. I'll crank the saturation way down here. There we go. Turn off the outline, if it's not already off, by clicking the little red slash. Zoom in a couple clicks on your canvas with the plus sign magnifying glass and draw a small circle. Remember, you can make sure that it stays a circle instead of an oval by holding down the Shift key. There we go. Recenter your sprite by clicking the select arrow, pointing at the sprite, and clicking and dragging until the small white cross snaps into the gray cross. Rename your sprite Star. And now, click on the code tab. Okay, we've got a star. Cool. But I want a lot of stars, like 50. And I certainly don't want to paint a different sprite for each single star. That is way too much work. What I really want is to ask the computer to make a lot of copies of this one star and to put the copies in all sorts of places. Scratch has a lovely tool for making copies of a sprite. It's called cloning. You can take a sprite and make a lot of clones of that sprite and then send them out to random spots. It's exactly what we want. In the orange control blocks, go find the Create Clone of Myself block. Grab that and bring it over. This cloning block is weird. It will create a copy of our sprite, but the copy won't do anything. It's just a clone. It looks the same, but it doesn't have any of the same properties as your base sprite. Up until now, we've just been parking all the scripts into green flag events. Now, we're going to redo everything. We're going to make the green flags only create clones. We're then going to make the clones do all the normal sprite stuff. So, for the code, first get a when green flag clicked event block and drag it over. Now snap your Create Clone of Myself block into that flag. If you click the green flag here, you can try it if you want, nothing will happen. It will make a clone of the first sprite, which sits right on top of the first sprite, and that's all. So let's fix it. We just want that clone to go somewhere else. But if we tell the clone to go to a specific place to use a Go to XY block, then all the clones will go to exactly that same spot. We'll get our first sprite, then the clone will show up in a second spot, and that's it. We don't want them to go to a specific place. We want them to go to a random place. As a programmer, you will need computers to do random things all the time. You might want an enemy character to go in random directions, or you might want rain to come down in random paths, or you might need, this is a wild example, but it could still happen, you might need a lot of stars in random locations. So, to do that in Scratch, go to the orange control blocks and grab a When I Start as a Clone hat block. Next, go to Motion and grab a Go to Random Position block. Also, right now, we are only making one clone. We need to make a lot. If we want the computer to do something more than once, we don't have to repeat ourselves. We can make the computer repeat it. Go to the orange control blocks and get a Repeat 10 times loop. Bring that over and snap it in around the Create Clone of Myself block, like so. Now, click the green flag. Cool. But I don't want 10 stars. I want 50. Well, with a repeat block, it's very easy. Just change the 10 bubble right here to read 50. Now click your green flag. So good. But you know, not every star is the same size in the sky. It would be neat if we could get all these stars to look a tiny bit different. Well, we can. We just need two blocks. First, go to the purple looks blocks and grab a set size to 100% block. Snap that into the When I Start as a Clone script, just under the Go to Random Position. But we don't want each star to be 100%, which is normal sized. We want them all to vary a little bit. So, go to the green operators blocks, and you will find the coolest block. Get a pick random 1 to 10 block and snap it into the 100% bubble on the set size 2 block. Now, we don't want the size to vary between 1% and 10%, which is what we would do if we left it like it is. The pick random block will create some random number between the two numbers in its bubbles and then feed that number into the set size 2 block. So let's fix the range. Change the first number to 50 and the second number to 150. Now the stars will vary between half as big as normal, 50% bigger than normal, and everything in between. Click your green flag. Hey, cool, huh? I love it. So pretty and so easy. Next time, we'll learn how to make the stars twinkle. Thanks a lot. See you soon.